Hello everyone. In this session, we will see how to write the business rule to calculate product revenue. For any calculation script or business rules, we need to write set commands first. So we have used set update calc off. In general, SPACE calculates dirty blocks only, but if we turn it off, it calculates anything mentioned below the script. And we need to restrict the calculation to budget scenario, and we need to run it only for the year for which user is running this script. We can create a variable, runtime prompt variable, so that, or we can use a substitution variable which we have created. And I have created three variables, runtime prompts. Let's see how to create a business rule runtime prompts. Let's go to system view and click actions variable designer. This is where runtime prompts variable can be created. So by default it appears like this. Expand this one, and if you want to define it globally for all planning application, you can select it here. Generally, we define at application level so that the variable will be available for all databases under this application. So I have created two variables now, RP scenario and RP year, runtime prompt year, runtime prompt for scenario. Let's create a runtime prompt for a version. Click new, RP underscore version. And I want to select member from the dimension, so the type should be member. And as soon as we select member, options change here. Under dimension type, this belongs to version dimension. You can give a default version so that it will be used when we are checking the syntax of the script. It's a runtime prompt. So what is the text you want to give? Maybe select version or enter version, something like that. You can save this. I have created a runtime prompt for entity, RP underscore entity, dimension type entity, and default value, any lowest level member. Select entity, click runtime prompt and select entity. Let's save this. Now we have runtime prompts available for the script. So let's use those runtime prompts. So RP entity, RP version and year. If at the rate is member calculated, I want to make sure this particular calculation units multiplied by unit price is calculated and stored in calculated member of the data source dimension. So you can write a comment here. So a comment in a business rule or calculation script starts like this, and it can end with asterisk and slash. So now product revenue is equal to units multiplied by unit price. We have a fix and end fix. So this will run for Jan to December budget and for runtime prompt year, version and entity, and currency is local. Level 0 descendants of all products member, comma 0, or you can use at the rate relative also, relative member of all products. So within the product dimension, for all products member, it takes level 0 members and will run this script. Now check for the syntax, validate. This will give, this symbol will give validate and save. This symbol here, it validates and deploys, and it prompts for saving the script. So let me check validate now. So during validation, if the runtime prompt has no default value, then it will ask us to enter the value. Let's see with an example. So I'm removing the default value for entity runtime prompt. Let's save this. And let's try to validate the product revenue. Now you see, you have another prompt. It says select entity and we need to enter any value. Remember, this script is not getting run or executed for this particular entity now, but it's only validating the syntax. You can select a member here also. Select the entity, click OK. Now the script is validated, fine. Let's deploy the script. So this is the reason why it's better to have a default member in the variable designer. Now deploy the script. Let's go back to the form and we will see how to attach this business rule to the form. Click on the business rule. Now our business rule appears on the left hand side. You can select it. So these are selected business rules. You can remove the other default rules. Right now our business rule which we wrote appear on the selected business rules. So this is business rule properties. How you want to execute this business rule and what are the parameters? Run on load. When a form is open, the business rule will be run. We don't want to do that. So when data is entered and user clicks on save, then run this business rule. Use members on form. What does it mean? As you know, we have seen there are runtime prompts. Runtime prompts for year, version and entity. I want to use the members that are available already on the form. If you click, it will not ask users to enter. So use members on the form means, here we have current budget year. We have not hard coded the form with current, with year, with version. We are still using a substitution variable. This is very helpful in projects. If you have 30 forms, you don't need to go to each form. This year, year is FY20 is the budget year. Next year, it will be FY21 will be the budget year. I don't want to go to each form and change the year. So we change only substitution variable. And when we run the business rule, automatically it picks up the correct year. Save and finish this. Open the form now. I have entered some data for units and unit price and the product revenue on the third column got calculated. Let's change some data and see if there is any issue. Let's save this. As soon as we save this data, business rules will be calculated. But we have not hidden the prompts. That's why it is showing the runtime prompts. We click launch to run the business rule. We have changed the units and unit price. It's a simple script. 100 multiplied by 4, we should be getting 400. But we are still seeing 350 only. There is some issue. We know that product revenue formula is correct. But if you notice, in order to make users not to enter any data directly into this revenue products combination, I have used parent member from data source dimension. Let's go back to manage dimensions and select data source dimension. This is where we are distinguishing whether the data is directly uploaded or calculated. So we have used plan total member, which is a top level of the dimension. So that means either this member should have dynamic calc property or we should get this aggregated, which is nothing but aggregate or calc dim. We need to run that command now. So we can say aggregate data source. If it is a sparse dimension, we can use aggregate command. If it is a dense dimension, you have to use calc dim. So this is a sparse dimension. Let's say aggregate data source. We need to put it in a fix command. So we cannot put it in the same fix command because this range will be different
If I write aggregate product in the same fix, it will fail. So you can copy rest of the combinations. So let us leave it for now and validate the script. Rule validated with no errors. Deploy the script. So the script is deployed. Let's go back to the form again. We don't need to change any data. Simply save it again and the rule will be run. Product revenue is changed to 400 and the total of these two, this is the product one, product two, and the total also aggregated to the parent level. And we can also view the same form in SmartView under Plan PSS. You can refer SmartView section of this training to see how to connect to SmartView and how to open a form. So now let's open product units form. And now you see the data aggregated and the users can enter units and unit price also can be entered. New product 451000 will get calculated using the business rule. When you submit, there is an option called submit here in SmartView. When you submit in the SmartView also, you will be able to run the rules attached to the form. Here are the runtime prompts. If you want, we can save. Otherwise, it is picking it up from the point of view. Let me show you. If I change this entity member to some other member, refresh first so that the entity 2101 appears. If I try to submit this, now automatically entity is taken as 2101. In this session, we have seen how to enter unit and unit price, how to write a simple business rule. In next session, we will see the same example for business rule, but we will write a business rule in graphical interface. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in next session.